Here we are, with an exclusive interview with the infamous, self-proclaimed greatest guitarist of all time, Benny Penn. Benny has separated himself from the outside world in recent years, after charges of indecency when he exposed himself to a flock of sheep, charges of which he was later acquitted. This is his first interview in nearly 5 years. So, Benny, tell me, how did you feel about all that controversial graffiti in your hometown? You know, when you were growing up and playing in clubs around Athens?
Well, you know, I just think it's terrible. The kids these days defacing everything with their penises and their vagina.
No, Lord, no. I'm talking about the graffiti that read, "Pen is gone."
Oh, okay. Well, you know, it's the kind of thing where, you know, you look at it and you think to yourself, No, there's no way I could be God, you know? I'm short, I don't have the white beard, I can't perform miracles. Well, you know, at least not off stage or out of the bedroom anyway, right, ladies? But then I really, you know, I sit back and I really thought about it, you know, googled a few ideologies here and there, some belief systems, if you will, and thought to myself, you know, maybe, just maybe to these people, I am God. And you know, in the grand scheme of things, everybody needs something to believe in, you know, everybody needs something to keep them going from their day-to-day lives, but, you know, I have to say that I think that me and my music are a little bit less ridiculous than the next idea, you know, it's like, did you know that there are actually native tribes around the world, I'm talking real people around the world, that worship cows, that's right, they worship the bovine. You know, when you think about that, you put that all into perspective. You know, I think about that and I have to say, surely, worshipping me is not nearly as ridiculous as worshipping a cow, right?
Certainly not.
When you really, you know, when you really boil it down and you sift all the shit, you know, and you put it into perspective, you know, it's the kind of thing where it's like, you know, I may not be the God, you know, but to so many millions and millions and millions of people, you know, I may be a God, and that's worth something.
Millions? Really?
I mean, you know, I have created a life. They talk about all I've got children. Well, I've got hundreds of children. At least a couple in every city I've ever toured. You know, I've just been touring that long, you know. You get into all sorts of trouble when you're on tour, and, you know, all sorts of things. But that's beside the point, anyway. What I'm trying to say here is, you know, that maybe one day, you know, I can be Pope, and I can be king of my own Vatican City, if you will, you know? 1 minute, you know, that gives me a really good idea. Hold on. Got an idea for a song. Vatican City!
But how about when you were in your first band? You made similar comments, and you were attacked, and even banned in some venues, when you said, and I quote, "We're more popular now than Jesus."
Surely at the time I wasn't more popular than Jesus. I mean, I was young and big-headed and stupid. But now, however, I'm certainly bigger than Jesus. Take the graffiti, for example. I mean, I don't see any graffiti that says Jesus is God, do you?
Playing with Benny, man. A religious experience. I cried out of the womb for the first time. It was like I was riding a merman with black stallion unicorns by my side.
This last thing I don't really want to say, but I have to. Your last album, Wet Dog, was not a huge success, commercially or critically. Why?
Wet Dog was written in sort of an obsolete vernacular.
That's cool.